because I found you. If not, I'm probably just wasting my time with this call, but it's worth a try. So, your name's John? John? I think it's John. Well, my name's Peter, and I'm a former night guard of Freddy Fazbear's, and as far as I know, you've never met me, but you're just as deep in this as me. Every survivor I can find can help us to get out of here, so I'm gonna try to keep you alive, John. I can't protect you, but I might have some useful information on what to do when they wake up. And by they, I'm talking about your childhood friends. Now, before you start questioning me how you could meet them after they were killed back in the 80s, there's a pretty simple answer. You're dead, John. No, I'm not joking. I'm unsure of how you died, but I know that you definitely made a mistake by doing so. I think I should probably explain myself here, so let me hurry up. You might have already noticed that this place probably looks familiar to you, and there's a good reason for that. This is Fred Bear's family diner. Kinda. To be exact, it's an eternal purgatory. Your memory shaped the place, so for you, it probably looks like a mix of wherever you last worked or lived and Fred Bear's. On that, you're pretty lucky. You could have gotten a much worse look for this place in your head, but that's trivia you don't need to know about. What you do need to know about is that this eternal purgatory could potentially be escaped from, and that I have a plan of how to do so. However, you do need to assist me on this, and it's not quite ready. I'll explain it to you tomorrow, but for now, it's an important step for you to look onto the office table with the fan that is located next to you, and get the audio tape that is in there out of it. You'll need this if you want to escape from here. However, it appears that we are really running short on time, and I should really hurry to explain to you what to do against your friends. If any of your friends come to your security office, you're gonna experience them from a more, hostile side. See, I currently don't know exactly what happened to them, but I know something really weird must have happened to their spirits. They're pretty messed up and broken, and I don't think they're very mentally stable. See, what I noticed when encountering them earlier, when I was still the only normal person here, was that upon putting their side on me, the only way to make them wander off is to hide from them. Now, the only way to really hide from them, in your case, probably is just getting out of sight from the doors they appear in, so if you see anybody in them, run somewhere that is as far away from the doors as possible. I don't think anyone's active tonight, but I could be wrong. There's this really weird daily cycle of activity in the slumber for them, so I'm going after that. I might have gotten it wrong though, so don't rely on too much on me. I think that's everything for now. I'm not entirely sure if your friends will be hostile towards you, but I can't throw the idea out. I don't think they'll be able to remember you at all, really. All they really want is... Damn it, I need to go right now, or one of them's gonna find me. Stupid yellow bear suit. I'll get back to you later. I'm hoping you made it past night one. Night two's gonna be a little trickier. I hope you've come prepared. Where I left off. The reason these spirits want to kill you, and this is just a guess on my side, it's because they need what's inside of you. And by this, I mean the plasma your ghostly body is made of. You see, my theory on why these ghosts turn to animatronics is that someone or something made an attempt of manifesting them into physical bodies out of thin air. It sounds impossible, right? Yeah, that's the thing. Whoever made the attempt failed. Most likely horribly. That's why all these characters look so weird and broken. So in order to fix themselves, they possibly need a way bigger plasma source. And I think that's where you come in. You're an unarmed adult ghost, which makes you a potential meal for them. They don't see us as humans, John. They only see us as a chance for survival. And can we really blame them for it? Why am I asking you questions? I'm leaving a message, not actually talking to you. Damn it, Peter, get yourself together. Moving on. I think only one character is going to become active tonight, and that is the bear character I did not identify. I have no idea what exactly he is, but it appears that his manifestation was somewhat fruitful. He seems to be glitching in and out of existence, which is why I dubbed him Am I Real? Clever, right? Yeah, not really, You really need to keep an eye on that guy, though, or else you're going to run into massive problems. If he's fixed and clean, you're absolutely fine. If he's broken, on the other hand, watch him for a few seconds. He should turn back to normal. If you don't keep him normal, he's going to really hurt you. Now, remember that plan I mentioned? Yeah, you do. This plan is it's still a work in progress, and I don't have everything ready yet. However, I'm pretty sure that there is more audio tapes like the one you hopefully picked up from the reporter yesterday. And they are going to appear in a different camera every night. If you see it, click on it with that mouse on the old computer in your room, and you'll probably obtain it. Now, I'm leaving it up to you. Don't waste too much time listening to this. He might already be active. Thank you. Okay, I'm back again, and I'm gonna hurry this time, mostly because they're probably pretty active right now. Now, there's this big mess of parts and stuff that has appeared only after you first arrived. It appears to have lamps in it, and for some reason, it's full of sharp teeth. It looks like something straight out of a goddamn horror attraction, to be honest. Anyway, once it's assembled all of the parts, it is going to appear on your ceiling. I think the best way to just keep it away is to look at it when it's up there, so make sure to do that. It dislikes being watched. Remember the plasma source issue? The old plasma source that was used to create these messed up ghosts is, it's still around here. If it's there, play dead. Instantly. Look at the ceiling and do absolutely nothing until you hear it walk away. That's pretty much the only way to keep it out. It doesn't like other ghosts. I've seen it attack the others multiple times, actually. It's pretty interesting. It appears to want back what's theirs. Well, I'm gonna leave you to it, and don't forget about collecting the tapes. Good evening, John, if you're still alive. I have good news and bad news for you. The good news is that I pretty much got the plan figured out. And the bad news is that there's going to be another character around tonight. I'm pretty sure this character is something from the location we had back in 87, or at least something similar to it. It's a puppet, but it's full of these disgusting, slimy tentacles. If it appears in the window behind you, just look at it, and it should go back to where it came from. Tomorrow there's going to be another active enemy that is something new for you to watch out for, and that one might be the hardest to take care of. But for now, make sure you get through the night. I'm going to try and get you in on the plan and that new enemy tomorrow, since I'm running out of time. There's a robot fox around me somewhere, and I'm pretty sure if I don't cover myself, he's not going to allow me to ever send you any message again.
Thank you.
Alright, so I really need to hurry. They're moving really fast tonight. You know that new enemy I mentioned? It's me. Well, it's not really me. To be exact, it's my physical remainings from back in 1993. Yeah, I've been here for a while, if you couldn't guess by my knowledge of these ghosts. This character's gonna send you a voicemail onto your computer's e-phone client, and if you don't delete it fast enough, the computer will autoplay it and probably cause him to find you really quickly. However, the hard thing about this is that deleting these voicemails requires a password. To find the password, switch to the camera that contains the purple curtains. It's camera 4. There's gonna be a sign in there once the message reaches you, and this displays the password, which you quickly need to type in. The e-phone autoplay gives you some time, but there's something that doesn't. The reason the curtains are pushed aside is that the character is in there and is going to begin making his way to your office once the message reaches you. If you're in front of the computer or doors in the general area when he reaches your room, you're fox food. So be really quick about typing in the password and instantly go to the other side of the room so he doesn't see you when he comes to look for you. And never look into camera 3 when he's out. Okay, now that the important stuff to your survival is out of the way, I'm going to explain my plan. If you've been listening to the tapes you've collected, they include recordings of yourself and your friends, and him as well. These obviously aren't real recordings, but instead memories of your messed up childhood compressed into physical form. My idea is that collecting all these may allow you and your friends to move on from purgatory and become free ghosts. Basically, facing your past would make you get over it, make you find your peace. So, for your sake, find all of them. Talk to you later. All the characters that might appear take behaviors like the ones I mentioned to you earlier in my call, so it'll be easy for you to figure out how to deal with them by simply looking at what places they appear in. This allows me to focus more on telling you about my plans, so as you might have guessed, there's tapes in my dimension of this place as well. These contain memories that are obviously based on my past, which, just like yours, is heavily connected to Freddy's. That's why I'm in the same purgatory as you, I suppose. Every story has a beginning and an end. And then there's another part after the end. This little hidden epilogue that nobody expects. That, in this case, is this entire place. Our stories are connected, and so are our lives and deaths. I tried connecting all my tapes, but I didn't manage to get all of them. I only had one day each. They never return. Only once can you find them. The rules of this place sure are weird. These 10 nights decide about freedom or purgatory for all of us. John, please, for the love of God, don't mess up like I did. All these poor little children are just trapped in here, roaming as monsters without any choice but to try and kill. It's pretty sad to watch, to be honest. But hey, maybe you can put an end to this. Talk to you later, I hope. Hello there. I've been noticing some weird differences during these past 6 nights. These characters' slumber cycle appears to be messed up. Some wake up and go to sleep at points that I never really marked them to. They repeated the same pattern I had for years now, but they seem to be suddenly changing their mind. Maybe they're trying to mess with me, maybe they're trying really hard to make me seem like a liar, because I'd be giving you false facts. I don't know. But also, I think there might be another piece to this puzzle. I've never seen it before, but I found it. I tried using it on the exit door to see what's behind it, but the key didn't fit. I'll try to figure out what these are all about later. In the meantime, just focus on collecting those tapes and staying alive. I'll talk to you tomorrow. So I have really, really important news for you. I think I actually did find another piece to this weird freedom puzzle. There was a second key lying around. I picked it up and I'm gonna see if anything happens at the end of this 10-night cycle. I also don't think there's any keys in your dimension of this place, since thinking about it, I'm pretty sure that these are a reference to a very bad trauma that happened to me. Why the force behind all this is giving them to me, I have no clue. But they just have to be important. They can't be meaningless. Oh, and I think I figured out what causes these differences in their slumber cycles. There's been something here. It came here with you. It's been hiding, but sometimes I think I've seen a glimpse of it. I think I must have just marked it off as Amiriel, since their costume texture appears to be really similar, but it's not him. I noticed that it makes way louder footsteps than Amiriel, so what I'm guessing is that this is something big, and that these loud footsteps are interrupting the ghost's slumber cycle. I don't quite know what it is, but I have a very bad feeling about what it might be. I don't want to chance it. If it is what I think it is, though, we are, we're screwed completely. I'm gonna find out what it is now. Talk to you tomorrow night. Absolutely done for. See, there's things you can't expect to happen. This is one of these plot twists. Remember Garvey? Don't pretend you don't. He's here, and he's gonna erase all of us. I don't know why he is so massive, or what reason he still has to do harm to us, but I've seen him do bad things, and so did you. And he's not gonna stop doing these things until we're all gone. Stupid motherfucker. I am such a stupid motherfucker! Right now, he's closing in on me. He's breaking them. He's shattering all the ghosts into tiny little pieces. It's the most corrupted, wrong thing that I've ever seen. It's time to say goodbye. He's outside of the purple curtain. I hit him after he took apart Foxy. The keys, John. The keys.
You
absolutely done for. See, there's things you can't expect to happen. This is one of these plot twists. Remember Garvey? Don't pretend you don't. He's here, and he's gonna erase all of us. I don't know why he is so massive, or what reason he still has to do harm to us, but I've seen him do bad, bad things, and so did you. And he's not gonna stop doing these things until we're all gone. Stupid motherfucker. I am such a stupid motherfucker! Right now, he's closing in on me. He's breaking them. He's shattering all the ghosts into tiny little pieces. It is the most corrupted, wrong thing that I've ever seen. He's outside of the purple curtains I hid in after he took apart Foxy.
Three.
absolutely done for. See, there's things you can't expect to happen. This is one of these plot twists. Remember Garvey? Don't pretend you don't. He's here, and he's gonna erase all of us. I don't know why he is so massive, or what reason he still has to do harm to us, but... But I've seen him do bad, bad things. So did you. He's not gonna stop doing these things until we're all gone. Stupid motherfucker. I am such a stupid motherfucker! Right now, he's closing in on me. He's breaking them. He's shattering all the ghosts into tiny little pieces. It is the most corrupted, wrong thing that I've ever seen. It's time to say goodbye. He's outside of the purple curtains. I hid him after he took apart Foxy. Absolutely done for. See, there's things you can't expect to happen. This is one of these plot twists. Remember Garvey? Don't pretend you don't. He's here, and he's gonna erase all of us. I don't know why he is so massive, or what reason he still has to do harm to us, but I've seen him do bad, bad things, and so did you. And he's not gonna stop doing these things until we're all gone. Stupid motherfucker. I am such a stupid motherfucker! Right now, he's closing in on me. He's breaking them. He's shattering all the ghosts into tiny little pieces. It is the most corrupted, wrong thing that I've ever seen. It's time to say goodbye. He's outside of the purple curtains. I hid him after he took apart Foxy. The keys, John.
Turtle, you can't do this to me! It's a shame. Such a shame. I didn't really want to do this. I didn't want to start doing this again. But they just won't shut up about it. It's not my fault. I can't control my physical mutations. It's not like anyone ever cared for the truth. All they ever wanted was to harm me. But this will be the end. And not without consequences. I'm going to be recording the most important parts of my plans here, as a reminder for myself. It was easy. Just so easy. All I had to do was surprise him. He couldn't even fight back. I dragged him into my purple car and brought him to my basement. He bled out real quick. The human body's hilarious. So fucking pathetic. I dumped him in the dumpster behind the cake bears. All his friends don't even know yet that they will suffer the same fate. My god! This is most certainly beginning to be fun. There was this hot 15-year-old that was part of the kids' friends group. You know, it was fun. She screamed, screamed, but nobody heard her. It was so much fun. She's in one of the suits now. Just a little more time until Fred Bears is going down as well. But hey, I'll find my ways to catch her at the others. Oh my god, incredible! It took 5
$5 to make a teen put his little brother into the mouth of the Fredbear suit. All the blood. It was wonderful. The sound of the cracking skull made me chuckle quite a bit. Now, Fredbear's is definitely going down. Today was my first big strike at Freddy's. I took 5 of the kids to the back room, and that's all I had to really do. The doors of the back room is soundproof, so nobody heard them scream in pain as I cut them up with my knife. 3 years, and yet not caught. At this rate, they'll never find out that it's me. I've been snooping around a little bit, and I've heard people complaining about the smell in that place. The staff has apparently not even noticed the corpses yet! This is great, really great! Soon they'll find them. Five more out of the way. However, I think I might have a problem. I think that, That Fritz guy. I think he's onto something. He neatly investigated the parts in service room today. Thankfully, he didn't find them. He would have framed me. Needless to say, this might be a problem in the future. He found the bodies. I didn't have much of a choice, so I knocked him out. I didn't want to do this, but I can't have anyone interrupt my plans. All of John's friends are dead, so now just John himself is left. I knocked Fritz out and put him into the cake bear suit. They stupidly kept it in the back. I dumped him into the crawl space after putting him in the suit. If the moisture down there doesn't snap the locks, then the panic he will have when waking up surely will. It's just John left. It's been 11 years since I've begun. And nobody suspected a thing until now. My brother bailed me out. He knows what I did. The police asked me about the murders today, and I think I might have made them suspicious. If I don't get rid of Peter, he's gonna get me locked up. I didn't want this to go as far as killing family. But do I really have a choice now? Sorry. That's it. He's dead. Except inside the yellow bear suit. But John's still alive. I don't know how long it will take me to find him, but I will. And he will not like what happens next.
Thank you. Thank you.
it. He's dead. Except inside the yellow bear suit. But John. John's still alive. I don't know how long it will take me to find him. But I will. And he will not like what happens next.
Thank you. You